Okay, but besides all that, that was long ago. That show ended in 1977. Oh, it didn't? Oh, what?
No, everybody thinks it did. No. Yeah, I don't know where people are getting that information. And it's like the internet is great, but the internet can be so wrong on so
Oh,
many levels. The
absolutely.
information gets out there, and if it stays out there, it becomes set in concrete. Now, this show, and a lot of people think it started in 71. It didn't. It started in 1972, and it ended in 1979.
Oh, 79. I had the 72 right, but ended in 79.
Yeah, August of 79 was the last day we shot a show.
Okay, so 1979 is when Emergency ended, and Randy, I'm sure that you haven't just sat, 8 hours a day for 30-something years eating popcorn and watching reruns. You've done something other than that, and that is that you have really got engaged in fire safety and in the paramedic programs and things like that. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what you've been doing concerning that, besides the acting, what you've been doing concerning helping firefighters and paramedic safety awareness?
Right. Well, after the show ended, I actually did two other television series after that. Of course, if you're not a firefighter, you would have never seen it. And I also then went back to New York, and I did a show called The City for 9 years. I did Emergency for 7, so I did another show for 9 years. But I guess it was in 1982, Galveston, Texas asked me to come down and speak. So I did, and I thought, wow, this is kind of cool. I'm pretty good at this. So I've been speaking all over the country on the history of paramedicine in the country, in America, which basically means in the world because we started it all. A company came up to me, a group called the Masimo Corporation, and they make a device called the RAD-57, which is if you're a firefighter, you pretty or a paramedic, you pretty much know what it is. It non-invasively can calculate how much CO you have in your blood. Now, you have to understand, in 75, while I was shooting the show in Emergency, I almost died of carbon monoxide poisoning, and two firefighter paramedics saved my life.
Was this on the set or
No, no.
private?
It was a faulty furnace in a house that I was renting out in Topanga Canyon when I was shooting the show,
Okay.
and I really, really came close to dying, and from that point on, I had a new awareness of just how ironic it was that about 2 weeks before this all happened, we did a show on Emergency. We did a whole rescue on carbon monoxide poisoning. You would think that I would have learned a lot from doing that show, but it's such an insidious problem, and firefighters are so exposed to this, and paramedics will to a degree, a lesser degree, but police officers are too, because when they're called on a scene, they don't know what they're getting into. Like if somebody says, "Hey, I haven't heard from Martha, in days. Can you go check and see if she's okay?" Well, they go in there. The house is filled with carbon monoxide. You can't see it. You can't smell it. And all of a sudden, the police officer is overcome, and he could very easily, and has in the past, very easily die right on the spot. It will kill you on the spot.
Wow.
So once I realized this, they asked if I wanted to go out and speak about this, and I said, yeah, absolutely. Well, the IFF, the International Federation of Firefighters, asked if I would be a spokesperson and to go out and do these classes teaching firefighters the dangers that they put themselves in. And as a result, I did a film. I did a film for Masimo and asked them if they could not advertise, their RAD-57 because I didn't want it to cost like a commercial. And treat this more as a PSA. And they said yes. And so we sort of together started a website called thesilentkiller.com, or actually .net.
Right.
And if you go on there, you'll see the film, but you'll also see the statistics that the general public just doesn't understand and doesn't know that 2 years ago, 114 firefighters died in the line of duty as a direct result of carbon monoxide poisoning.
Wow. Wow.
And that is just a statistic that I never want to see again. And if there's anything I can do to change that, I will.
Well, we appreciate that. Do not even being firefighters, because we appreciate our firefighters and our paramedics. That's for sure. That is, that is a, I know they get paid and all that, but you know, the sacrifices they make and the concern they have to save people's lives and the urgency, we really appreciate that and appreciate what you're doing and trying to save them. But also CO poisoning, Randy, significantly can increase long-term health risks as well. Is that correct? Even if we don't die, what are some of those long-term health risks that people experience?
Well, the number, you know, the number one cause of death to firefighters is not fire. It's not building explosions and it's not building collapse. It's heart attack. And that's the number one cause of firefighter deaths in this world. And more the studies are showing that the low-level exposure to carbon monoxide is having a great effect on the health of the firefighter's heart. And we're seeing more strokes, we're seeing more heart attacks, and now they're beginning to realize, wait a minute, there's a correlation here. Just even low-level, just by the mere fact that once the fire's out, the first thing a firefighter does, I know, I did it on the show, the first thing a firefighter does is take his mask off to perform overhaul. Well, that couldn't be a worse time to do it.
And what is because overhaul, real quick?
I don't overhaul mean is once the fire is out, now you got to tear all that stuff down.
Uh-huh.
Now you got to rip out the walls to make sure that there's nothing burning behind there. Well, when you're doing that, when you're ripping all that out and it's just sitting there smoldering on all this, there's this toxic soup that is just rising up off the fire ground. And if you don't have your mask on, you've got an elevated heart rate, you've got rapid respirations, and you're breathing it in. Now, what they're finding is that in the long term, it's weakening your heart. It's actually destroying portions of your heart, leaving you open to stroke, leaving you open to loss of motor skills, and of course, heart attack. And they're now seeing that correlation, and they're now trying to tell the firefighter, this isn't John Wayne days anymore.
Right.
You can't just run in there without a mask and put out the fire. Well, most people know that, especially the young ones do. But what I see on a daily basis, because I still with L.A. County Fire, maybe two, maybe three times a month, and I see it all the time. They take their mask off. And I ask them, well, why do you do that? Even though I did it when I was doing the show. But I did it because everybody else did it.
Did they tell you, because we watched you, Johnny Gage, and thought that's the way it was done?
No. So far, nobody's actually said that, man. Thank God.
All right, I'll keep that under our hat then.
Yeah. But what they do say is that, well, because it's hot. Well, my response is, hot? Since when are firefighters afraid of heat?
Yeah.
When are firefighters afraid of sweat? You know, just the trade-off is heart attack. The trade-off is stroke. Loss of motor skills, cancer, big time. Cancer is really a major problem with firefighters, and they're finding out more and more. It's because of exposure to these toxic chemicals, not just CO, but carbon monoxide. And if it's an older building, asbestos is floating around. So
right.
Why would you want to take that mask off?
Especially in those older buildings. There's lots of, I mean, I worked out in St. Louis, did a lot of demolition.
Oh,
right?
Well, yeah.
And I'll tell you what, it's all about us. So so to see the video, we can go out to thesilentkiller.net, okay?
That's right.
And Randy Mantooth, if they want to go to your fan site, is that randymantooth.com?
Yes, I believe it is.
And just briefly, there's a fan site out there?
There's a whole bunch of sites out there.
Okay.
But my official site is randymantooth.com. I don't really care what you look at. It's all fan based, and it's all kind of clips of emergency, and it's pictures of my past, pictures, you know, of my present. But then there also in connection with it is a business site, which if you want me to come and speak, it kind of guides you where I've been, where I've spoken, say in the past year, in the past 5, 10, 15 years. And if you want me to come and speak, these are the people you have to talk to. These are the people that, you know, this is the whipping line you have to get into.
Gotcha. Gotcha. All right, Mandy Mantooth, once again, he was Johnny Gage on Emergency. We appreciate you spending your time here talking a little emergency history and also how important CO2 poisoning is and how we need to be aware of it. Randy, we really appreciate you being on the program today.
Gary, it's been my pleasure. Thank you very much for having me on.
Thank you, sir, and best to you.
Thank you.
Okay, that's it. Okay, but besides all that, that was long ago. That show ended in 1977.
No.
Oh, it didn't? Oh, what?
No, everybody thinks it did. No. I don't know where people are getting that information. You know, it's like the Internet is great, but the Internet can be so wrong on so many levels. The information gets in 82. Galveston, Texas asked me to come down and speak. So I did, and I thought, wow, this is kind of cool. I'm pretty good at this. So I've been speaking all over the country on the history of paramedicine in the country, in America, which basically means...
Concerning helping firefighters and paramedic safety awareness.
Right. Well, you know, after the show ended, I actually did two other television series after that. Of course, if you're not a firefighter, you would have never seen it. And I also then went back to New York, and I did a show called The City for 9 years. I did Emergency for 7, so I did another show for 9 years. But I guess it was in 19 out there, and if it stays out there, it becomes set in concrete. Now, this show, and a lot of people think it started in 71. It didn't. It started in 1972, and it ended in 1979.
Oh, 79. I had the 72 right, but ended in 79.
Yeah, August of 79 was the last day we shot a show.
Okay, so 1979 is when Emergency ended, and Randy, I'm sure that you haven't just sat, 8 hours a day for 30-something years eating popcorn and watching reruns. you've done something other than that, and that is that you have really got engaged in fire safety and in the paramedic programs and things like that. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what you've been doing concerning that, besides the acting, what you've been doing